called Punjab, which is known for its rich culture, high agriculture produce, natural as well as human beauty. Men of Punjab are highest in English speaking after Kerala, but at night, because they are drunk at night. I'm also one of the kind from the state of Punjab. Good evening, Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster, and distinguished guests. As most of you know my name, Pankaj, do you know the meaning of this name? It's from a Hindi language. A Pankaj means a lotus flower, which grows in a muddy water, rises above the surface to bloom with a remarkable beauty. It is a symbol of purity and great beauty. My family gave me this name, keeping some aspiration in mind that one day I will break the family stereotype. Yes, I did. It was two. One, I completed my chartered accountancy exams. In our family, no boy was completed their graduation. And the second one, boys in our family are afraid of having girlfriend, and I had five till I got married. One of them is friend of my elder sister, whom you know as my wife. In my educational front, whatever I am today is all because of the efforts and the hard work of my parents. Because till my graduation, there was nothing clear to me what is the life all about in the future. And because I could see a settled business from my father. But life has kept something else for me. There was two turning points in my life in 1996 and 2003, which made me a person standing in front of you. In 1996, my father lost all his business, and it was a very tough time for the family, that even they cannot afford my studies. But my family always encouraged me to complete my studies. My father actually wanted me to be a chartered accountant, which is one of the respected degree in the finance world in India. And because as it is one of the respected degree, one of the premier institute in India, though I was not very brilliant in studies, and it was a challenge for me, I decided to go for chartered accountancy exams, because it was not very expensive, but it requires rigorous studies. Because at that time, the result ratio was coming 8 to 10% in that. In the year 2003, it was the third time when I failed in my CA exams. And I decided to give up and pursue the ordinary course in the accounting field or the finance field. I still remember the day and the words of my father ringing loud and clear. We are taught you must blame your father, your mother, your sister, school and teachers, because it's not, never blame yourself. It's not your fault, but it's actually your fault. If you want to achieve something great, you are the person have to change yourself. That day I realized the hurdle faced by my father in his life, and he wanted not to face the same by me. From that day I just started studying seriously, concentrating only on the one aim in my mind, that is the dream of my father, chartered accountancy. In the year 2005, after 2 years, I passed the CA exam with highest score in auditing in Northern India, and I cannot explain the magic it created at my home. I was feeling like I have achieved something great in my life. I could see the gleam in my father's eye, and he was proud of me and mom for a moment. That day I felt everything is possible if you are passionate, if you are determined to your goals, and nothing is impossible in that. Ever since I started giving myself some challenging situations. Like, I came from my hometown after completing my CA exam, came out from my hometown to a capital city of India, Delhi, join a big corporate where I got exposure to travel around India and Southeast Asia. Then the second, six years ago, I got an opportunity to work in Saudi Arabia, which is one of the decision my family was not willing to take. But I took this decision and joined the Toastmaster Sand Dunes in 2015 just to develop my public speaking and leadership skills. And third, to marry my fifth girlfriend. So I still have two unachieved dreams in my life. One is to take my parents on the world tour, and second, to establish a charitable institute where I can help to the needy people who can pursue their higher education. So at last, I would say, always keep your dreams close to your heart and be passionate about them, and let's see what happens. Thank you.